Good afternoon, everyone. I, Preeti Kiran, is here to present my e-poster on the topic application of image processing techniques in examination of scanned documents. As we all know that we are living in a digital era, so the use of computers and the use of computers has increased at a very large scale. So nowadays, forgers are basically using the computer to create a manipulated documents, and which could be a challenging task at the time of examination, because there could be any kind of manipulation like addition or deletion in any document, which might change the original document. And therefore, the forensic document examiner must have the proper knowledge about the various manipulations which could have been done on the document and how to analyze them. Now, we have some special image processing techniques or tools which could be used to detect the manipulations done in the scanned documents. So this study basically aims for the examination of computer manipulated documents with through various softwares or image processing techniques which could be used to examine them. Now, in this study, I have basically divided the study in two phases. In the phase one, I have collected the samples and manipulated them. I have collected the samples which are more prone to manipulations, like detailed mark sheets, ID cards, and checkbooks, and other than that, bank passbooks or the basic documents or the important government official documents which could be manipulated for any personal or official use. Then I manipulated those documents by use of the softwares like Paint or Adobe Photoshop. First of all, I added some of the features. I added some of the features by using Paint, in which I just selected the area in which I want to add the and add any kind of text or image. Then I use the text box, text tool, and added the text over that. There were some kind of observations. The second thing that I did was the use of eraser tool. I used the eraser tool in Paint box, in Paint software, and deleted some of the things from the big mark sheets or the documents that I collected for the purpose of examination. Then I used the software, image processing softwares like Adobe Photoshop and Picasa, to check out the manipulations which were done on this on those documents. And during my study, I observed basically five of the features, like irregular spacing between letters and words, discrepancies in the fonts and design, as well as the size of the letters and the words, and non-uniformities in the background. Whenever we use any eraser or addition in the document, the background get distorted or get disturbed completely. Now, that non-uniformities in the back in the document could be seen by the help of magnifying glass, when we scan any document, there is a dotted line on the entire document. And when we add or delete something from that document, the dotted line becomes invisible or get disrupted because of the addition or deletion. Therefore, that gives the idea that, yeah, there is some kind of manipulation has been done on this on the document. Then next comes is the irregular spacing. Whenever we delete any text or document from the document, then there is some kind of irregular spacing, as we can see in the figure in front of irregular spacing between letters and words. The space between the nine and in is comparatively larger than the spacing which is present in the entire document. And there's also discrepancies in the font size and font size, as the original document might have the size of 12, and the forger might have put the a font of larger or smaller size, so that would create a manipulated effect or a alteration in the document. Then next is the fonts and the font and design of the inserted words and letters. If we insert any word or letter in the document, then the font size and design might get differ, because the original document might have a slightly different font than than the one which could be which the forger had used to insert it. So after all these observations and I came to the conclusion that now computers are most commonly used to commit certain crimes other than in the era of cyber crimes, and they could be used to commit crimes in other fields of forensics as well, like documentations. Now in this study we looked at how system generated documents such as those with simple backgrounds changed, and the documents which were manipulated using image processing softwares were also examined using the same softwares, and a number of features were extracted out to check out what kind of manipulation was done and how it could be examined when a forensic examiner receives any scanned document for the purpose of examination. Thank you, ma'am.